I was wrong. With our busy lives and careers and children, the amount of laughter in our relationship was decreasing very rapidly. As I started research in neuroscience of romantic relationships, I learned when there is a genuine connection between people, laughter is one of the first things that they experience as a confirmation of the relationship well-being. And then intimacy comes next. And after that, they get married and live together. Well, when things don't go right, laughter is the first thing to go. Second thing is intimacy. Third is your house. So after extensive marriage counseling, my wife and I still did not know how to bring laughter back. And we made a very difficult decision. We decided to go our separate ways, but focused 100% on the well-being of our children. So we celebrated all the holidays together, all the birthdays together, and we're still good friends. I'll show you a picture of our last family gathering. When I look back on this journey, there's one night in particular that stands out for me. The kids were with me for a weekend, and I was reading my daughter a bedtime story, and it ended with me reading to her, and they lived happily ever after. And my daughter was about 7 years old at that time. She looked at me with her big blue eyes, and she said, "Daddy, why didn't you and Mommy live happily ever after?" And I came up with a great answer. I said, "Go to sleep." I couldn't sleep because I wanted to intelligently answer her question. This became my quest. This is the main reason I went to University of Pennsylvania. I was fortunate to get my master's degree and study under the supervision of Dr. Martin Seligman. He started a graduate program in positive psychology in the University of Pennsylvania, and he handpicked 30 students from around the world to be in his inaugural class. And I was very fortunate to be one of those 30 students. My research under the guidance of Dr. Seligman was mainly focused on proving that laughter is the gauge of happiness. And here's what I found. When two people laugh together like best friends, they attract each other like magnets. Would you agree with that? Applaud if you agree with that. And people who've fallen in love with one another also attract each other like magnets. Would you agree with that? Applause. That energy is called magnetism. Now, we can feel that energy, but we cannot see it. So I thought maybe magnets can show us what we can't see with our naked eye, and they can unlock the mystery of this romantic attraction. And if we know it, then we can understand it, and then we can repeat it, that honeymoon stage, over and over and over again. I didn't know much about magnets. I didn't know physics of magnets. I knew that they erased my credit cards. So I needed an assistant. I put out the word, and I got a lot of people interested, and I picked somebody who was the most intelligent, the most educated, the most attractive. So ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to my assistant. It's a one-man show, folks, all right? So here's what I did. I took two magnets, and I put the word give on the red, and I put the receive on the white. And the reason I did that, because in the beginning of the relationship, I totally believe this is how we create happiness and laughter. We give and receive. We give and receive. Yep, yep, yep. Okay, folks, if you need me to slow down, it's okay. And then, but there's this space in between magnets. And we know what brings them together. It's magnetic field. And that field is so powerful. It's a force of nature, more powerful than gravity. But when you take two people together and something brings them closer, there is this amazing energy that philosophers and poets have been trying to figure out for thousands of years. And we describe it with this four-letter word. What is that word?
Love.
Love. And we all want it, but we don't know how to duplicate it because it's kind of mysterious and elusive. So I thought maybe we can come up with another word that would bring people together and makes them happy, and then can give us the instructions on how to sustain happiness and laughter in your relationship. And I found that word, and it's magical. And the reason it's magical, because if you use it, it has the power to create happiness and laughter in your relationship forever.